Hello, all you positive heads out there. Thanks for tuning your beautiful brainwaves into another episode of the Positive Head Podcast, where we are firmly convinced that creating success and happiness is rooted in understanding the ultimate nature of reality and the fact that as human beings, we are all immensely powerful fractals of the one and only source consciousness, which creates and animates all things. Now, of course, understanding this powerful truth is one thing. Applying this incredibly empowering wisdom to everyday life? Well, that's another. Which is exactly why we provide you with a fresh serving of soul food for thought 5 days a week. To help constantly remind you of what matters most. You are it. And I'm your host, Brandon Beecham. I'm the reflection and extension of you who will be here each Wednesday interviewing a different consciousness changemaker. And on the other 4 weekdays, leading the way to ensure that your perspective is consistently expanded, your vibration is constantly elevated, and your heart is overflowing and full. Also, this episode of the Positive Head Podcast is being brought to you thanks to the support of Gaia. If you're not familiar, Gaia is the go-to source for streaming consciousness content online, and you can sign up for your first month for only 99 cents at gaia.com/positivehead. That's spelled gaia.com/positivehead. Check it out. All right, all you positive heads, welcome back to another episode. Here we go again. So happy to be here with you guys, as always, and connect, share, grow, learn, etc. Going to read a little bit today. Felt inspired to pick up Oneness again. You know, from time to time, I feel the urging to get some goodness from the amazing download that is the book Oneness, received and transcribed by Rasha. And that is, I guess the first printing, it looks like it was in May of 2003. So it's been around for a little bit. And as I always like to say, it's sort of like, for me, I see it as the handbook to ascension, handbook for ascension, as we all upgrade vibrationally, expand our awareness. Thank you guys listening who've been listening for a while, where you were at when you first started listening to this show, and where you're at now. You've many people, I know, because a lot of you guys have reached out to me, have had an experience, and I know me as well, expanding, understanding more, seeing more. And as you are expanding and continuing to see, understand, feel more about what the heck is going on here, what is the truth, the ultimate nature of reality, what is truly going on, there's sort of a process involved in that, and things that will unfold and happen, and that you can expect along your own unique journey. There'll be a lot of things that are unique to you, but overall, there's a process. And this book was written as a guide of what you can expect from someone who claims to have received divine guidance, channeling, download, if you will, of what to expect. Whether that's true or not, all I know is the information is very high vibe, very informational, very just resonates as truth at in every cell of my being. And I've certainly, since I originally read the book, you know, a decade or so ago, I've definitely seen some of these things unfold for myself. So what I'm doing and have been doing for quite some time over, you know, months, maybe even a year now, every now and then when I feel like reading, I'll just grab the book and open a chapter randomly. And today we're going to explore chapter 16. And the great thing about the book is you can really pick it up anywhere, and it's going to, you don't have to read it in chronological order. Obviously you could, but you don't need to. So before I do that though, I would like to take a moment and read a review on iTunes. As you guys know, I love my iTunes reviews, iTunes being the holy grail of all things podcasting. Not only do they help us to reach new listeners, and we've been reaching a lot of people through random searches on iTunes, you know, and that's thanks to you guys who are taking the time to review. So I applaud you and appreciate you. And if you haven't done so, please take the time to do so. If not, that's okay too. I'll still love you. This one came in by, FGRSKL. Not quite sure how to say that, so I'll spell it out. And the review goes a little something like this. This podcast is a new one for me, but quickly moving up to my favorite. If I need guidance or help, I turn it on, and it often feels like the episodes were made for my life and pertaining to what is happening in my life at the moment. When Brandon says, "I love you," it makes me smile, and you can feel his love. This podcast is a highlight of my day. Peace, light, and much love, Brandon. Thank you for making this podcast. Keep up the incredible work. Aw, thank you, FGRSKL, for sending the love back my way. I feel you. I feel your love. And completing the circle of love that I'm putting out into the world by sending it back my way. As I like to say, love is the only thing we can give away, and it only grows. You cannot divide it. It expands. So that's why I do what I do. And of course, you're all an extension of me, and I am an extension of you. And so it only makes sense to send out love, and what you send out is going to come back to you. So as I always also say, and I haven't been saying it as much as I used to, it's a selfish kind of love, right? It is the kind that, knowing, hey, you're an extension of me, and by giving it away to you, I'm going to receive it back, and everyone wins. It's a win-win-win, and that's what we're looking for in life, right? Is always looking for how can we find the win-win. If there's not a win-win, tap out of it. Find, take your energy, put it somewhere else. That's such a powerful mantra and motto to live by. Anything you're thinking about doing and investing your energy into, look at it and say, is this a win-win for everyone involved? And if it is, cool, go forward. If it's not, rescind your energy, find somewhere else to put it. So important, because if it's not a win-win for everyone involved, if anyone loses, you lose. And that's such an important one for people to get. Certainly has been an important one for me to get in my own life, for sure. So that being said, I am going to start reading here in a moment. One other thing I would like to throw out. If you guys aren't on the Facebook group, Positive Heads with an S, it's a private Facebook group where you have now over 3,000 P-heads, as I like to affectionately call you guys, including myself. 3,000 plus P-heads and growing. And it's such a beautiful, beautiful thing to see all you guys connecting and sharing and supporting one another, and not having to worry about opening up and the whole world seeing it. Especially, a lot of us, a lot of people in the group are new on their spiritual journey, if you will, and they want to have some level of privacy and so that's why we chose to close the group. Of course, there was a question about it a long time ago, where should we close it or open it? And so people keep responding to it months and months later. So it gets brought back up like it's a new question. It's been closed, and it's become sort of a joke in the group. Those of you know who see it keep popping up like it's still up for debate. We closed it a while ago, and so we did that for most people seem to want that. So that's what we did. All right. Well, let's see. Jumping right into chapter 16 of Oneness. And at the top of the chapter, there's always a little breakdown of what you can expect in this, in each chapter. This one, it says, "The Sacred Science of Manifestation, Transforming Possibility into Probability, Overcoming Karmic Conditioning, Manifestation as an Emerging Art Form, Building a Foundation for Mastery." And if you guys can hear, I'm a little bit hoarse, so bear with me on that. And here we go. As you journey ever deeper into the transformation process, you'll become intensely aware of the signals provided by your life circumstances and by your state of physical health as to your vibrational levels relative to all that surrounds you. It will be quite easy to determine where you stand in your own process at any juncture simply by becoming aware of the ease or the difficulty you experience in manifesting your heart's desire in your day-to-day life. You'll find that you have become the observer and the object of that awareness simultaneously, and the process of assessing your state of beingness and modifying your choices accordingly will become an integral part of living. This approach is what many term conscious. For, under the conditions now well underway, there is not the luxury of random action unsupported by focused intent. Every action, every thought, and every nuance of every choice each add their measure to the vibrational whole and contribute to the creation of the reality you experience as your life. You'll begin to feel pressed to assess your life direction again and again as the process intensifies. And you may find yourself feeling compelled to make radical changes in your life circumstances that would result in the severing of ties with situations that no longer serve your highest purpose, both professionally and interpersonally. That's funny because that's exactly what I was just talking about, right? It will come obvious to you that certain relationships and certain activities have become obsolete in terms of your spiritual evolution, and it will continue to become clear to you that you cannot continue to justify perpetuating situations that leave you drained energetically. You may already be keenly aware of the intensity of the influence of your surroundings and the individuals with whom you choose to interact upon your state of being. Four, the veils of separation have become very thin, and one experiences an intensified energy exchange with every being and every situation in which one chooses to engage. It is certainly in one's highest interest to be aware of the energetic environments in which one places oneself and to make conscious, focused choices accordingly. It may be necessary for ties to be severed with affiliations that no longer resonate harmoniously. There are no rewards given for martyrdom on this journey. There is no advantage whatsoever in prolonging that which no longer serves your highest good, and there is no yardstick with which that determination can be made beyond your own inner knowingness. This is the time to become attuned to your life priorities and to selectively weed out the individuals and activities that are not uplifting. You have no obligation whatsoever to carry others down the path on which you travel. Those who journey by your side must be energetically autonomous if the association is to be mutually advantageous. Those who continue to try to coerce you against your natural inclinations to accommodate their personal preferences only serve to drain your energies and distract your focus. For the focus of this process is upon the highest expression of self. By honoring your own personal truth and resisting the conditioned inclination to compromise in the name of diplomacy, you succeed in serving the highest expression of the energetic whole with which you are interconnected. Becoming disciplined in where and with whom you choose to interact is highly recommended, with care that those choices come not from subjective judgments of others, but rather from focus upon your own highest good. Until you develop the ability to be vibrationally impermeable, you would be well advised to be aware of the extent to which your energetic state of being is influenced by everything and everyone that you encounter. As the ability to hold one's energy stabilizes over time, it is likely that the vulnerability that characterizes this stage of the transformational process will diminish. When one reaches those levels, the natural sense of detachment that one adopts in the early stages of this process as a protective mechanism gives way to a sense of having merged with conscious intent with all that is. For some, the entire process is instantaneous. For others, focused on letting go of layers of constraint, this stage of energetic vulnerability can be prolonged and agonizing. One can continue to ride the vibrational roller coaster throughout the transformation process, or one can choose to step off and seize control of a vibrational state of being that one comes to realize is self-determined. It takes some practice before you become acclimated with the new levels and the techniques for harnessing your awareness of the shifting energies as they occur in your daily life. You become accustomed to sensing surges in energy and begin to recognize those moments as opportunities to put forth in the form of focused thought or verbalized intent what you wish to have manifest as form. The ease with which results seemingly fall in your lap will amaze you at first, and as you begin to become comfortable with your newfound abilities, it will feel very natural indeed to be choreographing the dance of your existence and watching the performance virtually simultaneously. One develops an instinctive sense of the timing of casting the net of one's consciousness upon the seas of opportunity, and the results that you manifest leaves little room for doubt that the nature of your reality and the ground rules for optimum performance here have shifted radically. It is not the same world as it was when you were taught how to survive here not so very long ago. The page is turned now, and a radical deviation from what you may once have believed was your life script is written in bold on a new page of reality that appears before you everywhere you look. You may choose to cling in denial to what you have been told and what you have been taught. Or you may dare to recognize what is undeniable to your own senses and what is irrefutable to your own experience. And you may be amongst the first to know the wonders of a world in which you are truly a pioneer. The guidebooks have yet to be written. For those of you who have ventured forth on uncharted ground will have forged a trail through your own experience of day-to-day living that the others who follow in your footsteps will herald as gospel. The truth you speak as you share your life experience with the others who walk beside you during this extraordinary time of transition will form the foundation of a reality that is both new and timeless. Your world will have shifted radically from the standpoint of where, in the crossroads of time and space, you are acting out this particular drama. Yet the abilities you have begun to manifest, and will increasingly come to do so, are commonplace in the realms of reality towards which your world evolves energetically. The ascension experience of which you are an integral part is one that is in process eternally. It is a motion of unity, questing towards the completion of its own heart's desire, delighting in the reuniting and the bounding with all that is and all that it continues to become. You are of that essence at every level throughout creation. And in this lifetime, you have chosen to give yourself the experiences that carve the truth of the momentum of change indelibly in the stone of your consciousness. You have chosen to be present and to partake of the voyage. You have chosen to venture forth and confront the experience of the great unknown in order that you might relay that knowingness to others who have yet to encounter the shifting tides of your reality. You are amongst the forerunners of a new paradigm who will set the precedents upon which the ground rules of the new world will be based. You have identified yourself to yourself and have dared to stand alone in the light of your inner truths, while others, still cloaked in the self-righteousness of inconsensus thinking, throw stones as the very fabric of that reality unravels. And you have exercised the wisdom to stand firm in your truth and watch quietly as the cards are shuffled and reshuffled and the lives of others succumb to the shifting tides of change. It is not a question of who is right and who is wrong, for each is convinced of the validity of his beliefs. And as such, that is the reality and the parameters within which each individual operates. What will separate those who will thrive in the new energies from those who will perish in this framework for how one chooses to proceed in the face of the evidence presented? Those who cling tenaciously to a world as it once was will face increasing difficulty despite playing by the quote-unquote rules. Those who recognize that those rules are redefining themselves in the moment are best equipped to ride the currents in the direction in which they are headed. The energy of non-judgmental receptivity best equips you to translate pure awareness into action that is inspired, yet sensitive to the energies that will carry them to fruition. Developing an attunement to the energies as the surges peak and then wane helps you to harness the potential for manifestation and to avoid the low ebb in thought, word, and deed. Simply by being aware of the flow of the energies around you and the ease with which you are able to sense a response to the creative feelers you send forth at the inception of a concept, you learn to merge energetically with the moment and become one with it. The timing of one's response to a given set of circumstances can make a dramatic difference in the effectiveness of one's efforts. The ability to sense when to assert one's energies and when to withhold them is a powerful asset to be cultivated and developed. Knowing when to relinquish one's grasp on a situation and allow the energies to carry the potential inherent in the circumstances to fruition is a key to harnessing the power with which you have now been gifted. It is not enough to recognize the potential in the ebb and flow of the energies as a means for timing one's own actions. One must be sensitive to the balance between action and non-action as a tool for manifesting one's will. Oftentimes, the action of choice is simply to do nothing at the appointed moment and to allow the elaborately interwoven variables surrounding a given issue to settle into place quite naturally. This is the difference between manifesting a result and allowing a result to manifest. Often, the latter approach is the more effective and produces the most desirable outcome. Patience is a powerful skill, and you would be well advised to exercise it often while strengthening your ability to harmonize with the energies that surround you. It is not always possible to harness a vibrational high point and the potential it offers for delivering a desired outcome. For even though your efforts might increase your chances of manifesting that result, the outcome of highest vibration has often been predetermined by factors that are beyond your conscious control. In the realm of possibility, all variables are present and vibe vibrationally for the chance to manifest in the reality you experience. All are, in fact, materialized as form or experience in the infinite field of possibilities that surround any issue or crossroads. In the determination of which combination of variables will carry the highest electromagnetic charge and thus materialize, karmic patterning plays a powerful role. Conditioned responses pre-programmed by the life choices of all concerned on a given issue weigh significantly in transforming possibility into probability. Much can be done to counterbalance the influence of such factors, yet they form the foundation of the creation of reality and cannot be discounted in your efforts to manifest a less likely result. Do not feel that you have failed in your quest to amplify your vibration and respond in a conscious way simply because the result you most desire is not forthcoming instantaneously. It takes much time and practiced, controlled response to elicit a particular result and to offset the likelihood pre-programmed into certain pre-existing variables. As one progresses as a conscious practitioner of manifestation, the full scope of this fascinating art will come under careful scrutiny. And like any art form, the art of manifestation will invite mastery, as it does in other realities. One's very life circumstances become testimony to the skills one brings to this, the ultimate arena of creativity. For the medium is unlimited and the mode of expression embraces the perfection of the balance between heart and mind, between understanding the technical aspects of balancing and counterbalancing the energy and the passion one brings to the opportunity in question. The canvas upon which the masterpiece is created holds inherent in it all the potential pitfalls called forth by related instances in what one would consider to be the past or the future. Each in actuality is happening in the now moment and carries the appropriate electromagnetic charge that adds its measure to the equation. One is able to influence the balance of this complex combination of factors and draw forth a less than likely result by becoming attuned to the energies of the moment, the environment, and one's own being in timing and action or an expression of focused intent. One can become exceptionally skilled at transforming conditioned responses and overcome deep-seated factors that one once might consider to be karmic, reversing patterns that have manifested for lifetimes. When such skills are successfully employed, one can diffuse the dominant electromagnetic charges surrounding a given issue and alter the range of probability on the issue in question. To do so consistently will be the hallmark of mastery and the foundation of the field of manifestation. There will be many who approach manifestation as a science, and yet others who regard it as the highest expression of art. In times to come, the melding of the two approaches will yield a generation of highly skilled practitioners who will set the standard for transcending form entirely. At the present crossroads in time and space you consider to be your reality, you are at the outer frontiers of that new world of possibility. It will become common knowledge quite soon that each of you is creating the reality of your life experience, and the mindset you call quote-unquote victim consciousness will, by definition, be relegated to obsolescence. It will no longer be possible to blame another being or circumstances beyond your control for a given situation, for all experience will be recognized as self-determined or on a fascinating complexity of levels. And it will be necessary for every being to take responsibility for the part played by each in the co-creation of the reality of mutual experience. When it is no longer possible to deny one's own part in that creation, one is left little choice but to recognize the role one plays as creator and to cross a major threshold in the journey to oneness. The new world at whose brink you stand in the present moment represents a transitory stage that integrates the world of physical form and the world of instantaneous manifestation. The care one is able to demonstrate in applying one's newfound skills will determine the degree of joy or frustration one is able to experience. And a byproduct of the experience is the knowledge that there is no one to thank or to blame for any of it except oneself. In the present time frame, which represents a crossroad between two worlds, one is best counseled to be gentle with oneself. It will not enhance your situation in any way to blame yourself for what you realize is your own self-created condition. Likewise, it does not serve another for you to point out self-righteously observations and realizations culled from your own experience. The very fact that another being may be wrestling with circumstances you may have transcended testifies to the fact that they are schooling themselves experientially on certain issues. Real knowingness comes from life experience, and that alone. One can certainly intellectualize the process and try to force understandings that have been introduced by others or read about in books. Yet, until the lesson is manifested as poignant life experience, the real mastery of the lesson upon which transcendence is based is not possible. It serves no one to point out, condescendingly, understandings that one was fortunate enough to have learned through painful experience. It is counterproductive to pay lip service to platitudes one has encountered mentally and which are far from integrated as experience in one's own life. There is no need for apology or for condemnation for life circumstances that might be considered to be beneath one's level of understanding on a given issue. The very fact that a traumatic episode is manifested in such a person's life script is a clear indication that that person is working on the mastery of a particular issue. Beings who are inclined to counsel others are cautioned to become aware of the subtleties of the approach employed. By providing theoretical truisms or by meddling in the process of another, one nullifies the growth that might be possible in allowing the individual to experience those circumstances fully and to feel the emotions triggered by a given drama. When encountering another who is enmeshed in a major drama and is teetering on the brink of a breakthrough and realization, it is best to lead that person through carefully posed questions toward discovering the answer within himself. In this way, the lesson is driven home in a powerful way and is not wasted and likely to be repeated in order that the understandings be integrated as knowledge. Knowledge comes of having lived the lesson, not merely having intellectualized it theoretically. Be aware of your loving intentions and be sure that you are not undermining the progress of another by preempting his process of integration with well-meaning advice. You are here for you alone, and though you may delude yourself into thinking that you have transcended these times of transformation simply because certain metaphysical understandings have sparked a sense of recognition within you, the truth remains that your own process must be experiential if it is to form a strong foundation for the conditions to come. Honor your own process of transformation for the richness it is programmed to provide for you, and respect the magnificence of the process of the beings who journey by your side by allowing for the full expression of their humanness and your own. All right, that's the end of chapter 16. Hope you guys enjoyed. A lot to think about there. I love the idea of the new art form being the art of manifestation and your life being the sort of reflection of your own abilities in that in wielding that art form and in growing in your talent. I know it's an ongoing process for me and certainly for you guys as well. And it's just like another art form or sport where it's like, you know, you're playing golf, you're playing against yourself, right? It's art. It's not about competition. It's your own path, your own way. And so we need to be very careful not to get caught up in judging how good we are at this whole amazing emerging art form in comparison with others. We're on our own unique journey, and that goes for any advice that we're giving too. Be very careful, and that's good advice for me who gives lots of advice, to be very aware of people's own journey. And really what it's getting at is, like, you know, the more you can go within and get sensitive to subtleties and energy, the more inner guidance you're going to have, which navigates you through so many variables by learning to listen to that inner voice, that inner guide, your own intuition. And it's there waiting for you to work out that muscle, spend more time alone, spend more time meditating, call it in, and find yourself, weaving through all the things that are sure to come your way in the most graceful way, and to take the optimal path down the stream. Well, guys, I hope this podcast today finds your stream flowing smoothly. It's certainly been a smooth ride for me, and I do have a lovely song to leave you with that I really, really enjoy. Hope you do as well. It's You've Got the Love. It's Florence and the Machine, but the XX remix of the song. I love it a lot. I love you a lot. Hope you enjoyed the song. Until next time,
Float, float well.
Also, if you're craving more consciousness-elevating content, be sure to check out Gaia, which is my personal go-to source for streaming consciousness content on the web, where you can stream an incredible 7,000-plus exclusive videos covering 5,000 years of wisdom. As you all hear me constantly say, it's a daily conscious effort to maintain an elevated vibration, and if you're looking to journey deep down the rabbit hole to do so, then Gaia is the best place I know of to do it, period. And you can sign up for your first month for only 99 cents at gaia.com/positivehead. That's spelled gaia.com/positivehead. Check it out.
You got the love, you've got the love, you've got the love.